Hello guys, welcome to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. My name is Shivam Vijay and today in this video I am going to giving a demo on level control trainer with capacitive type of level transmitter. In this video we will see how the water level in the industrial processes is controlled with the capacitive type of level transmitter with a feedback loop of controlling. We will use the PID controller in this as well, and also we will see the current to pneumatic control converter by which we will control the valve with the pneumatic control valve actions. So this complete video will be very helpful for those who want to learn about the industrial automation, process control in the plants, and as well as about the instrumentation in the plant technologies also. So in this video, we will describe the complete working of feedback control, in which water is the medium which is controlled with the different pneumatic controlling and the current controlling of the complete process control system. The plant mimic is given with the complete trainer board. So we will study the complete plant working and how the process or the water flow and the water level is controlled in this process. Now I will explaining you all the parts of this complete trainer board. Then later on we will study the practical on it, by which we can understand the process controlling, which is level we are controlling in this trainer board using the PID controller. So this is the top upper part of this complete trainer board, and the order code is 5225 level control trainer. You can use this order code to find out all the specification about that and what you can learn from this complete trainer board by visiting our website, which is www.tescaglobal.com. Now we explain all the upper parts of this complete trainer board, then we will also explain the lower half also. So at the upper side, we will start with the capacitive level transmitter. In this, the level transmitter has the input of 0 to 500 mm for the length with the probe connected on the level transmitter. The output is given as a 4 to 20 milliampere, and this is a 2-wire type 24 volt DC working transmitter. So as the water level inside the water tank reaches up and down, this will give you the output current in the proportional output, and this will be fed to the PID controller. Then this is the level measuring tank. The level tank is made of acrylic material and has the length more than 500 mm, so that you can easily fill the water inside that about 500 mm. Then we have also a level switch inside. The level switch is float operated type level switch, and this will be help the motor to be off when the level is about to reach the top level of this level limits. Then we have PID controller. The PID controller is the main also component in which we will control the input of level transmitter, which is fed from the level transmitter and then minimized and calculated by the PID controller, and output is generated according to the set value inside the PID controller, and appropriate output of the level of the output and the output current is provided from the output terminals over here. Then on the front panel there are some switches for mains on, 24 volt power supply on, PID controller on, and pump on switch. So these four switches will be used in the process completely. Then we have T1, T3, the transmitter output, and the PID input terminal. When the transmitter output is connected directly to the PID controller with the help of these page codes will be provided separately with the kit, or you can find them inside the panel. And the T2, which is the ground output from the transmitter, will be connected with the PID input. Similarly, the output of PID controller, which is generated as per the error calculation, will be transmitted to the current to pressure converter as an input, and similarly ground is also connected with this. These are also the test point. You can check the values of current with the multimeter over here also. Then on the lower part we have some other equipments, in which first we will study the pump. The pump is a centrifugal pump of half HP of the power and works on the 230 volt AC power supply, and this is the surface mounted pump. It can throw the flow from up to 1200 liters per hour. So we'll adjust the flow with this input valve of the pump, and then the rest of the line is connected to the other equipments as well. Then we move on to the rotameter. The rotameter is connected directly line with the bypass line, also with the wall line also. Both the lines are interconnected and this will be going water and showing the water flow inside the rotameter. And rotameter used to calculate the flow and the liter per hour, and it has a range of 0 to 1000 liters per hour, and the connection has the half inch BOP SS304 is the made of this complete rotameter. And bob inside the rotameter is of SS304, so it will float and reach around any of the value at which the flow of the water is going on. Then we have pneumatic control valve inside the flow line. So this will be controlling the flow with the complete setup. The pneumatic control valve works on the air to close supply. The air is provided when the output according to the flow and set point is calculated with the PID controller at the upper part, and then the output is transferred to the current to pressure converter when the output according to the set point and the error signal, for minimizing the error inside the measured value and the actual value. The output according to the value is fed from the PID controller in the current form from the 4 to 20 milliamps, and this device works as the 4 to 20 milliamps is converted in the 3 to 15 PSIs. So the pressure is converted according to the current in the proportion of the output value. The pressure is provided from the pressure line over here. This is connected with the compressor, and there is the AFR unit, air filter and regulator unit. So there are moisture content and other impurities in the air from the compressor. So this will be rectified, and regulation can be also provided with the knob over here. So we can also regulate the air supply at the desired pressure. Then the desired pressure is need to be set according to the range of electropneumatic control valve, at which pressure this valve starts working. And when the pressure is going through this device of the current to pneumatic converter, in which the current will be sensed by the system, and according appropriate pressure is provided to the line, and this will be directly connected to the pneumatic control valve. We will also see the pressure at the pressure gauge over here. Pressure gauge of input is also given, and pressure gauge of output from the current to pneumatic converter is also observed at this time. Then the pressure is provided on the upper half of this, and there is a diaphragm inside that. The diaphragm is directly connected with the rod and spring inside that, and the spring will oppose the pressure, and the appropriate valve opening will be happen inside the valve. So this rod is connected with the complete setup. So when the pressure is applied on the diaphragm, this will push down the rod, but the spring inside it will be oppose the pushing of the pressure, and the appropriate value of the pressure and the appropriate opening is of the valve will be happen, and that's how we will control the level inside the level tank. Then we also have the sump tank, is also made of the polypropylene material, and this has the capacity of about 30 liters of the water inside that. So we will also require water to complete the process. So water is the main medium in this, so we will fill the water inside that. Before doing the experiment, almost fill the tank about 80%. So we have already filled the tank about 80%. Now we are ready to do the experiment in this. Before that, we will explain you the complete working of the capacitance level transmitter, how the capacitance level transmitter works, and how the signal is generated and fed to the PID controller. So now we will be understanding the capacitance level transmitter working. The capacitance level transmitter works basically on the principle of the capacitor. As we know, the capacitance is formed when the two parallel plates or the electrodes are separated by a specific distance, and it is dependent on the area between the plates, area of the plates, and the distance between the plates, and the dielectric constant of the material which is filled inside the capacitor. So over here we can see there is a probe of white probe which behaves as the first electrode of the capacitor, and the wall of the tank. In the tank, if the tank is conductive, behaving like the second probe of the capacitor. Over here we can see the distance and the area of both the plates is constant. So completely the capacitance will be dependent on the dielectric constant of the material inside them. So as we fill the water inside the level tank, so the level of the water when changes, the dielectric material or the dielectric constant of the capacitor or the capacitance will be changed as per the proportional value. So we will get the capacitance value as per the water level. Similarly, this will be converted and fed to the PID controller with the conditioning circuit, and the output of the capacitance level is converted according to the value in the 4 to 20 milliampere in the current form. Over here we can see there is a reference probe which is required to use when we using the non-conductive tank of the water level or any of the substance. So here you can see the tank is made of acrylic material. So we are using the reference probe over here. This is the second electrode inside that, and depending upon the dielectric constant of the material, we can change the different reference probes according to the capacitance measurement. So that's how the capacitance level transmitter works, and the value in the current form, which is 4 to 20 milliampere, and the analog output, which is fed directly to the PID controller, and then PID controller compares the value with the capacitance value or the level inside the level tank, and then which is generated the error signal. To rectify the error signal and to eliminate the error, the output is provided in the same 4 to 20 milliampere form, which is provided to the electrodynamic converter, in which the current will convert the pressure accordingly of the output generated from the PID controller. So this was the all explanation about the complete trainer board. Now we are ready to do the experiment, in which we will study the feedback control loop with the PID controlling of the controlling of level. So this is the experiment with the user manual. It is provided complete detailed. Follow the procedure according to the user manual, and then we can do the complete study of closed loop feedback control for the level, in which we will study the understanding of the concept of level control with the feedback and determination of the system response, procedure for optimizing of settings of PID controller to suit the process, and study the operation of level transmitter. Procedure is also given in the user manual. For this, the first step is to connect the test points T1 to T3, T2 to T4, T5 to T7, and T6 to T8 with the patchwork provided. So we have already connected them. Now switch on the mains on switch. So we will on the mains with the mains on switch, then make the switch on for PID controller and the 24 volt power supply. Then we will take the PID controller into manual mode and keep the output at 50%. And the reference manual of the PID controller is also provided with the kit, so you can easily control the PID settings with the PID controller manual. Then in the 6th and 7th step, we will control the valve position according to the given value. Then we will switch on the pump and see the PID controller value. The PID controller value for different channels are given in the user manual, so we will set the PID values accordingly. And then we see the auto, also we will see the auto tuning of the PID controller for the system response also. So now we will adjust the valves completely, in which as given in the user manual. So we will keep the bypass valve V4 in the closed position. So this is the bypass valve V4. So we will make this close, and V6 should be closed, and open the valves in the other sections. So V6 is the drain valve over here on the behind of this tank. Then V6 in the off condition. So we have closed the valve of the V6 as well. Then we will open the valve V1. V1 is completely open. V2 is open. V3 is open. And also we will open the V5 valve for the tank process, and partially open the V7 valve. So V7 valve is the output of from the tank. So we will need to close the V7 valve inside that, so that the water level from the upper hand will be inside. When the water level inside the tank is going on, the output will be completely going out from the partially opened valve from the drainage of this level tank, so that the level inside the tank will be maintained. So now let us study the settings of the PID controller. For this, we will first turn the mains on, then 24 volt power supply switch should be on, and then we will on the PID controller switch. So it will boot up the PID controller, and here after booting up, you can see the level inside the tank right now 0, and the set point is showing 250. For setting, the value inside the complete setup, you can follow the reference manual of the PID controller which is provided with the kit, and some of the basic settings are also given in the user manual. So we will do set the all values inside them. For this we will first press the select button over here for 2 to 3 seconds, and then we reach the menu section over here. This is the channel 1. If we want to go and change the settings of the channel 1, press select. So we enter the channel 1. Here the P value is given 23.5. So in the user manual right now it is having the 23.4 value. So we can change this by pressing the select again. Here the value starts blinking. Here this is ready to change. So you can use this up and down key to change the value. So 23.5 is right now set. After setting this, again press the select, value is entered. Now for the next menu and the next parameter, we'll go to press the next button. Here this is the value of I. This need to be 22 as given in the PID settings value. This is 26 right now, so we'll set to 22. So the values inside the user manual are given as per the setting and the test procedure that we have carried out with the complete trainer board. These settings can be differ at your place because it depends on the condition of the water, air and other climates. So it will be different for different places and different users. This will be can be also obtained with the auto tuning. We will also discuss it later. Now change the other value. The D value is given about 10, so we will set this value to 10. So here value is 10, press select to enter this value. Now we go to hysteresis menu. Hysteresis need to be 0, so we do not change this. Balance need to be 0, AR need to be 500, so we'll change this to 500. So 500 is our maximum level of the tank, so we set this to 500. Then the action should be reverse, so we will set this to reverse in the no condition. Set value low will be 0, set value high will be 500, TC1 will be 1, PLC1 need to be minus 5, so we will change this to minus 5. So this is the minus 5 value over here. Now to the next, PHC need to be 105, so we'll change this to 105. Then P cut should be 0, so we'll go to next parameter. P cut is 0, alpha is 40 and beta is 100. So these are the channel 1 settings that has been done. Press the back button when you done the settings. Now we'll enter the settings in the channel 6. For this again we'll press the select button for 2 to 3 seconds to go inside the menu of the channels. Here we will change the setting in the channel 6. So we'll go to channel 6, press select. PVT need to be 4 to 20, which is already done. PVB should be 0, PVF will be 500 and PVD should be 0. So these are the settings that need to be changed. Rest of the settings need to be at the default value. So do not change the value, otherwise you will get the response later or the output cannot be get accurate from the settings. Now after setting up the PID controller, we will set the pressure setting for this. For controlling the electropneumatic control valve, for controlling the pressure and the flow inside the line. So here you can see this is the AFR unit, air filter and regulator unit. Right now it is showing zero pressure because the pressure line is closed. So I will first turn on the pressure line, then using the AFR unit we will change the pressure value according to the required value. Here you can see
pressure inside the pressure regulator has been increased. So as per the safety measures, we need to set the pressure value near about 2.1. So pull up this knob for adjusting and regulate the pressure. If I regulate this in anticlockwise direction, here you can see the pressure is decreasing. And if you turn this to clockwise direction, the pressure will start increasing in the pressure gauge. So we need to set this to about 2.1 kilogram per centimeter square. So we'll need to set this about 2 and lock the pressure knob again here. Now it's do not move and the pressure will be set to the set value. So this is the setting of the pressure right now, and now we are ready to do the experiment with the complete setup. So now I will first start the pump and we will maintain the flow inside the complete line, so the air bubbles inside the line and the complete draining out will be going on. For this, we just need to open the V5 valve that we have already opened, so the line do not provide the water through the level tank. First the water directly going to the sump tank so that we can control the water flow. We can adjust the flow of the water first and then we will provide the flow inside the water tank. So now I'm going to turn on the pump. So over here you can see the water flow from the rotameter is about more than 1000 liters per hour. So we'll adjust the water flow with the valve V1 provided on the line. So this valve need to be controlled, and we'll close this valve carefully to adjust the pressure or the flow of the water inside the line. So we'll need about more than 500 liters per hour. So we'll set this about 700 liters per hour for the appropriate practical procedure. So adjust the valve according to setting of the rotameter. So we have now about 750 liters per hour from the rotameter. So now we are ready to do the experiment. Now we will turn off the pump again and close the valve position for the V5, and V6 will be open, and then the water will be directly flowing through the level tank. So now flow of water is now adjusted. So we are now ready to do the practical for level measurement with the feedback control. For this, we will first start the pump and open the drain valve of the level tank slightly, partially open this and turn on the valve V6 which is already open right now, and we will close the valve V5 completely so that water directly starts flowing through the upper line and starts filling inside the water tank. As soon as the water touches the capacitance probe inside that, the water level is transmitted to the PID controller. You can see the water value and the water level inside the transmitter is showing at the PID controller. And as it reaches the set point is 250 mm for this, it will start sending the signals, and the output percentage is also shown as the bar graph on the lower part of this controller. Over here you can see the bar graph is giving the output percentage, and this output percentage is converted into current and given to the electro-pneumatic converter over there, so that the electro-pneumatic converter provides the pressure applied to closing the valve position. So you can also see and adjust in 2 or 3 cycles the valve and the setup will be stabilized and the set point will be achieved according to the flow position and the draining out water. Here you can see the output level is about 80% or maximum from the PID controller, so that the valve is completely closed, so there is no water inlet from the pump here and water level inside the tank is decreasing. So it's again tries to matches the water level or the set point, and error signal is trying to minimize. So in 2 to 3 cycles, it will automatically stabilize the complete process, and then we can get the appropriate set point output. So here we can observe that the water level is about to control. So here we can see how the electropneumatic control valve works and behaves. Right now you can see the scale is about shut position and it starts opening right now and slowly increasing the valve opening so that the water from the flow line will start flowing and as the water level increases to the set point, it again closes the and shut off the water line through the electropneumatic control output. So output from the PID controller is directly fed to the current to pressure converter, and pressure generated according to the output with the proportional input from the PID controller, and then the pressure is provided to the diaphragm, and this is starts closing the valve and opening the valve according to the pressure line. Now if I provide some more output opening on the drain valve, it's again starts the water flow and open the valve line and starts maintaining the output inside the level. So you can adjust the opening of the drain valve so that the complete pressure flow will be going on, and we can adjust the water level inside the water tank. You can also observe the output pressure at the pressure gauge from the outputs. Here you can see the pressure is about 5 to 8 kilogram per centimeter square to the inlet, and the output pressure is converted through the electropneumatic converter or current to pressure converter. So here we can see the water inside the level tank is maintained near about 250. You can adjust and check the air output from your signals, and in some time of process controlling and complete feedback loop, you will get the appropriate output from the PID control level control trainer. Now we will start doing the auto tuning of this setup. For this, we just need to adjust the some settings inside the PID controller. For this, just need to press the select button once. Here you can see this is the manual section, standby section, programming section, and AT. AT is the auto tuning section. Then press select and change this to on, and again press select. It starts auto tuning the complete procedure and automatically adjusts the P, I, and D value according to the climate, according to the water level, and according to the density of the water. So auto-tuning will be happen automatically, and in some time we again reach the home screen where the set point is 250 and the water level is adjusted according to the value. After auto-tuning, we will also observe the PI and D value of that we have set from the manual and what we can get from our place. So auto-tuning has to take the 2 to 3 cycles for that, and then it will automatically sense the output and the complete process will go on as per the auto-tune settings. Here you can see it's completely closing and opening the valve again and again for the 1 or 2 cycles for getting the appropriate generated signals, and then the output will be sensed and given, and the process will be working on according to the setting value. Here you can see now we have reached the home screen again, reaching the set point. So it will again starts the set point, and will now reach the set point in some time. Here you can see output percentage is now about the 90 or 80%. So it's closing the valve position and it starts decreasing the level inside the level tank, and as the level is near about the 250 or 60, it's again open the valves and maintain the flow inside the level tank in the continuous operation. So we have reached about the set point. After auto tuning the process, you can enter the actual value and what the set point and what is the actual value is inside the tank, and measure the error percentage from the PID controller settings. So we have now reached the level which we have set in the PID controller. So level is controlled through this feedback control loop. Now this is the one reading and one set point over here. You can change the set point just clicking the up and down and button. So now we are going to change the set point and let us see how the system responses behaves. After setting the desired value, just press select once and your new set point has been entered. So now it starts increasing the level inside the water tank and the new set point is 300 mm. So we are now doing for the 3 to 4 cycles again, and then the system will again respond to the new set point. So that's how for different set points you can take measurements and observations in the observation table. Do your observation according to the procedure given in the user manual. Observe the PI and D value according to the auto tuning. Also we'll now match the PID values again in the PID controller after auto tune what we are getting. So 15.2 is the P value for this, and we have set the P value about 23.5. so this is after the auto tuning. I is 25, we have set it about 22, and D is about 4.8, though we have set this about 10. So these are the different values after auto tuning that we have get over here. Here you can also see the percentage of output. Here you can see the output and the wall opening is about 80% right now. In the percentage sign we can see this, and this is the set point. So we are now about to reach the new set point of this section as well. So this is how you can do all experiments and all the readings and all the observation in the observation table. Do maintain the different readings and see how the system responds and how much time this takes to maintain the level properly as per the set points. So after doing your experiments properly, first turn off the pump and completely open the drain valve of the measurement tank so that all the water outlet going in the sump tank and your measurement tank will be in empty condition. After completing all the experiments, make sure drain out the complete water from the sump tank and proper empty the tank and clean it properly so that when you do the next practical, next time use the kit, you will do not face any of the dirt condition in the pump, so that will not harm your the equipments and components connected in the lines over here. So here our demonstration of this level control trainer is now completed. I hope you will get the proper understanding of feedback controlling of the level, which is the water level that we are using here, and you have also understand the working of capacitance level transmitter. I have tried to explain the complete concept of capacitance level transmitter, how it is working, how we get the level, and also I have tried to explain the PID controller settings in which you can easily do the PID controller settings as per for the practical. And this is the controller manual is also provided with the complete setup so that you can easily do the all the settings for controlling, and you can perform all the experiments of this complete trainer board referring the user manual. Refer this video also. I hope you will get the proper understanding in this, so how you can do the practical on this complete trainer setup, and still you find difficulties, you can contact to Tesca Technologies Private Limited for all type of supports. And if you like the content of this video, and if you find this video very informative and useful for you, and you have cleared the concept about feedback controlling and the capacitance level transmitter and PID controllers,
then please press the like button. And also you can share this video to your classmates, colleagues and fellows, those who want to learn about the industrial automations, basic processes about the level controlling and the different equipment that I have explained in this video also. You can also subscribe our channel, which is Tesca Tech on YouTube. There are a lot of videos about the practical information with different experimental trainer kits are uploaded, so you can get the proper information and detailed explanation about them. Also, don't forget to press the bell button, so whenever we upload new video, you will get the notification about that also. Until then, thank you for watching this video, and we will meet in the next video very soon.